was back on that Saturday, singing, here we go.
I'm a taxi driver. I'm a striking docker. I'm a ballet dancer. I'm a zapatista. I'm a pop singer. I'm a winner.
I'm a winner.
I'm a winner, baby. I'm a winner, baby.
Oh.
I'm a bricklayer. I'm an ex-miner. I'm a single mother. I'm a bus driver. I'm a political prisoner. I'm a print worker. I'm a footballer. I'm a winner.
I'm a winner.
I'm a winner.
I think four men. Crosso, well supported. Excellent run by Pontypridd and McIntosh, the first time we've seen his power behind. Down now to Matthew Lloyd. Lloyd, another good master, late fitness test to play to Pontypridd. Now Neil Jenkins. Kevin Morgan sensibly brings it back. Could see that Simon Enoch was covered out wide. This is the ball they need, because Bath seem just a little stretched behind at the moment. It comes to Neil Jenkins. Jason Lewis still going back to the comfort zone of forwards, and it's John, he's right through, it's a try, dramatic solo try. Paul John has brought them to their feet at Sanders Road. Pontypridd lead, 5 points to 3, 6.5 minutes gone of the first half.
Good ball detection by Pontypridd. Jason Lewis takes it back in. But we win this ball. The back is spread out wide apart. Young John could see that. Straight through the gap. Back are going to cross the field, hoping, thinking that Pontypridd will move it out. Important try.
Bath back row was in. Robinson was looking towards Neil Jenkins. And Paul John didn't need the second invitation. Right through. Benetton Treviso, first kick, safe as they come. He turned his back long before Haag is standing away. Haag again, and they've laid it back well for Charlie Harrison. Harrison to Adebayo. Adebayo, the dummy switch, fine tackle, they're going in low. That was Jason Lewis that time, on his opposite number. Cat. That's Perry feeling the full force of a Dale McIntosh challenge. Almost every memorable tackle in this first half has been executed by Dale McIntosh.
Yes, the young centre, they learnt a lesson. Hit back in the tackle and then drops the ball forward. Outstanding defending all round by Pontypridd.
John Slighthome. Both Bath wings have been virtually unemployed. Took off, penalty against Pontypridd, but many a Bath player will remember the name and the ferocity of the tackle of Dale McIntosh. The whistling from the crowd, because the touch judge wants to come in and give some advice to referee Jim Fleming. Play goes on. But all this could be in vain. Whatever happens, it's out to Adebayo, can't take it. Frantic work here. Matthew Perry looking for support. It's Martin Haag. Adebayo tackled without the ball there. Jim Fleming allows play to go on. And touch judge still has his flag outstretched. It's a great period of play. There's a sense it might count for naught. Who goes slide to him? Harrison out. Robinson. McIntosh. Phenomenal tackling by the New Zealand man at number 8. He comes from the King Country. He's worthy of the title for some of his tackling this afternoon. And what about that for chasing from Big Greg Trotter?
Breathtaking, isn't it? The defence
by Eton captain Eddie Butler.
Well done, Dale. One of the outstanding performances of by a number 8 this season. You must be pretty pleased with that.
Yeah, obviously we're very chuffed with it. Bath are a very good side. We went out there, we gave it all, not just for Pontypridd, but for Welsh club rugby. And I think we've done ourselves proud, and Wales proud.
But it's not often that we can say that a Welsh team seems to have greater upper body strength and is making bigger tackles than their English counterparts, but it happened out there today.
Yeah, fortunately for us, money can buy a lot of things, but it can't buy pride. And with determination and a lot of camaraderie, we went hard out, and I think we got us a result that was well earned.
It was vile conditions out there, and yet the skills under pressure, they held up remarkably well.
Yeah, vile conditions, I don't think so. I think they were our conditions, and we related to them better than Bath did. To take nothing from Bath, they're a very good side, and I think at the end of the tournament, they'll be there and thereabouts.
Many congratulations, great personal game.
Thank you very much.
The Rhondda Valley, silence now, the colliery wheels have stopped turning. But expect the tranquility to be disturbed this afternoon. We're in a region characterised in the past by ceaseless industrial activity, but today preparing for industrial strength rugby. The eyes of the rugby world are trained on this small, close-knit community in a rugged part of southern Wales. Pontypridd and Brive have been punished for the explosion of violence in France 2 weeks ago. A game of outstanding rugby, but unacceptable ill discipline. Today, here at Sardis Road, it's Pontypridd, Brive, the return. In Pontypridd, Sardis Road, bursting with an 8,000 capacity crowd, willing their team to get the 2 points they desperately need. To get them, they have to overcome the reigning Heineken Cup champions, Brive, who a week ago said they wouldn't be coming to Wales. So a potentially explosive encounter between two sides who, let's say, haven't been the best of friends over the last couple of weeks. A repeat of the scenes we saw in France a fortnight ago, surely not an option. And it really is a carnival atmosphere. No doubt the Brive team should be feeling extremely welcome. Young and old, they're passionate about their rugby down here in southern Wales. The bands are playing and the crowds are expecting. So we've analysed a wonderful game here at Sardis Road in Wales, and the scene is getting towards dusk, and it's quite appropriate that the scene is settling after what was a truly dramatic game of rugby down here in southern Wales, the Rhondda Valley, staging what was, for us, a titanic struggle between two sides. No violence, just pure and beautiful total rugby. We'll see you in a few moments.